So I was talking about with Remco earlier about the hot Dutch market. The Dutch market's finally heating up, blowing up. Can you say a little bit about what you expect this year as far as capacity growth and the different segments?
Capacity growth in the Netherlands in 2017, if the residential market does not go in the negative growth because there are uncertainties with net metering legislation coming up, then I expect that over 600 megawatts is possible, and a large part of that will be SDE. The first solar parks have already been installed. The largest one is 31 megawatt peaks in Delfzijl, that's Sunport. And more coming online.
And can you spell out SDE?
SDE is a subsidy for so-called renewable energy, and the budgets for renewable energy are increasing each year. It's enormous now, it's 6 billion euros in the first round this year. Right. And the next round, the autumn round, is possibly also 6 billion. So in total might be 12 billion euros being poured into the regulation.
And you're estimated 600 megawatts.
Solar.
And largely commercial scale, utility scale?
No, the residential market is still the biggest, but the share of residential will become less because the commercial market is growing very fast now.
We saw similar in the US a while back. So what's the uncertainty with net metering that you mentioned?
Net metering is very lucrative because you can net meter on a yearly basis the full kilowatt hour price, and which is approximately 21 to 22 euro cents per kilowatt hour, which is mainly taxation, mainly energy tax. And the government is feeling uncomfortable because of increasing loss of income from the energy taxation. It is still a very minor total volume, right, but they feel that it's becoming a problem and they want to change the net metering system. Also because they say it's much too profitable. If cost price for solar might be in between 12 or 14 euro cents.
God forbid they stimulate too much solar growth.
And you get 21 cents, then they think that's not fair, and it should be changed. But big problem with changes in the Netherlands, which we have had frequently, is that you can have market collapse. And that's what they do not want. So
we saw the UK, Germany, Italy.
It goes everywhere.
Yeah. So it's this kind of, I guess, the global solar market is in some ways chasing, running around, following the next hot market. That's
The international investors know where the lucrative subsidy regimes are, and they are storming onto the market where the most interesting subsidies are, and they are making huge parks which cost a lot of money, and that's all from the regulation, must be socialized often, I have a slight fear that there's also a lot of international players going to the Dutch market making very big projects which for half are being paid by the civilians in the Netherlands. That's might become a problem.
So what would be your top recommendation or five for the best way forward for the Netherlands to not have a boom and then a bust,
to continue net metering for a longer time, and to have a very intelligent take a lot of time to have a very good transition regulation in which you more normalize that profit we have 14% obligation for 2020. We will not get that if we do not have support of civilians. And if you have if you're cutting net metering to a very non-interesting level for civilians, you will have no support for anything at all, because they say if you take away from us, then we will not accept that there's wind turbines on the edge of cities or whatever. So you need to be very careful not to lose the support of civilians, because they have up till now for solar have been the fundamentals of have been the fundament of the growth in the solar market.
And it's also a philosophical discussion to get into, but there's this ongoing debate of grassroots democratized energy versus, you know, just continuing.
Netherlands is very important because there's a lot of movement on that level. But up till now, the projects which have come from that, there are many, but they're also mostly rather small. So if you want to have big impact for renewable energy, then it cannot only be from the root grassroots level. You also have to have commercial, right. Yep. But you will have to have a good mix, have support from both.
And the more you can have a strong grassroots rooftop solar market, the better for various things, not just the energy market, but for
socializing and more connections in communities. In the northeastern part of the country, we have a lot of communities I wouldn't say collapse, but there's a lot of people going out of the area, so they are depopulating and the infrastructure collapses, etc. So you have to have, if you can have more bonding there by this kind of projects, doesn't need to have only to be solar or whatever, then of course that's good to the country. And if you're going to an energy transition, you will see energy production everywhere.
And I mean, we've gotten used to this term now, energy transition, but I mean, the Dutch market is not at the market share that South Australia is at for rooftop solar. So it's not like it's a disruptive influx of rooftop solar that's you know, they need to deal with to cut net metering.
Not yet. We have a very good decentralized system everywhere solar, but we have had a small minor problem in Groningen where there was an extra subsidy regime because of the earthquakes. You could, as a homeowner, you could buy solar with a very profitable incentive. And suddenly, in a very short time, because they were very angry about the gas earthquakes, a lot of people started to buy solar.
Yeah.
And they started to have small net problems because there was, so in so short a time, so much solar coming online there. They have fixed it.
But it's basically because of the rapid change rather
rapid
than
change.
Any kind of fundamental problem.
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
Well, that's where I lived for 5 months.
Okay.
So long before this happened, but like 9 years ago. But
that was long. That's in energy terms a long time.
Yeah, yeah, exactly. I wasn't even into solar back then. I was doing bike stuff. So so the place to be for bicycling. Also nice to hear that it became a hot solar market for a bit. Do you know what the market penetration is there, or, you know?
Groningen, not yet, because I subtract those data from Klimaatmonitor. This is a collection of several inputs, and they are dependent on the inputs, and the inputs are coming very slow. Mm. So we have to wait for next Klimaatmonitor update. It will largely come from the peer register from the net managers. But they are lagging behind enormously. I have already seen the effect in Groningen of the first regulation. We are now in the next stage in the Groningen subsidies. Mm-hmm. I have already seen a very large effect in Groningen that it was increasing very fast in relation to other provinces, for example. You could see it even on the provincial level that there was a strong increase in solar in a short time in Groningen.
So you have to share those numbers with us once you get them.
If those are available, I analyze them, make graphs from that, because graphs are very
exactly.
In fact, I do that a lot on my website. Nobody else does it, but they are strong visual tools to show the variation, the evolution, and the changes.
Yeah, they're critical.
Yeah. It's a lot of work.
So, I know. Believe me, I'm sure. There's a reason why nobody does it, right?
Yes,
a lot of work.
Yes.
It's a lot of work. But so, one or two last questions. So, do you have a favorite song?
Favorite song?
Yeah, I like to ask people their favorite song. Although
Sonne from Rammstein.
Okay, Rammstein. Oh, I wouldn't have guessed that.
They have a clip with coal mining and with a fairy tale from Snow White with an apple and the sun coming through.
I don't have to.
Sonne.
Yeah,
it's hard rock.
I will find it on YouTube.
It's hard rock.
And throw it into the article. And then what do you think?